What's up, y'all? Alright, so I got a conundrum here. I want y'all to tell me how you think this should be handled. Rock chip. Now, fortunately, it was already here when we picked the vehicle up. Next Best Thing did a good job doing an inspection on it, so it's on our bill of lading. But let's just say it wasn't on our bill of lading because it didn't exist. And I went through a construction zone, somebody passed me, rock popped up, dinged off the hood of that car. The big question is, who's responsible? Now, as you can see, I'm an open transport. What am I going to do as a driver to prevent that rock from hitting that car? Or that piece of hail, or the bird, or whatever. What can I as a driver do to prevent that? I don't have sides. It's not an enclosed trailer. Customer chose the cheaper rate of an open transport, assuming that if anything happened to it, the driver would be the one to pay for it. When the customer had the option of choosing enclosed transport, which obviously costs more, but then their vehicle shows up clean and protected. So the big question, and it's an old question, who is responsible for that rock ding? The driver of the truck who had no way of preventing it, or the owner of the car who has the exact same risk of driving this vehicle down the road and getting that rock ding, or putting it on the cheaper open transport and having the same risk of getting that same rock ding? Let's discuss it a little bit more right after this. Howdy, folks. Welcome to this episode of Trucking with Bones, a show that is generously informative, painfully honest, uniquely car hauling, and quite often, boring. All right, here we go. Welcome to Studio 825, otherwise known as the Mothership. What's up, folks? Say hi to the Next Best Thing.
Oh, no!
Well, never mind. He forgot to take his meds this morning. So, I want to talk to you for just a minute about the importance of doing a proper inspection when you pick up a vehicle. I've got a picture and a video just to show you how easy it is to get blamed for damage that you didn't cause. There are several areas that are very, very common for damages caused by car haulers. The rocker panels, the area of the body that runs below the doors between the tires, the front and rear valance under the front bumper and back bumper, and mirrors, scuffs on the outer edges of both mirrors, and roof damage. Those are the most common areas to have damage caused by a car hauler. Now, you can have other damage such as rock dings and chips and things of that nature. And depending on the specific contract and how well worded your bill of lading is, you may or may not have to pay for that. Because if you're in an open transport, you have zero control over whether or not somebody passes you and kicks a rock up. You can't prevent it. Now, if you get some of those curtain side open transports, that would definitely help. But by and large, open transport trailers do not have that added protection, and therefore it is not a driver-caused transport damage. It is a damage that happened during transport. And there is a difference, unless your specific broker contract states in it that you are responsible for any and all damages that occur while on your trailer. And that, in my opinion, isn't right to do that, because they are incurring the same exact risk to drive that vehicle down the road as they are to have it transported on an open trailer. they have the option of choosing enclosed versus open. So here's what happens. And I know a lot of people don't even really think about this, but obviously enclosed transport is quite a bit more costly, but it provides that level of protection that you do not have while driving your vehicle down the highway or transporting on open transport. So people will, most of the time, choose the cheaper option of open transport and then expect that even though they chose the cheaper option, anything and everything that happens to their vehicle is going to be paid for by the driver. So essentially, they're getting out of paying for the protection that their vehicle deserves, the protection that they want for their vehicle, which would be enclosed transport. They're getting out of paying for the enclosed transport rates, and they're putting that added, inherent, unavoidable damage liability onto the open transport driver like me. And then when that rock comes up, or that bird flies in, or whatever happens that's completely out of your control, they want you to be the one responsible. Same damage could have happened if they were driving it, and who would have been responsible then? Not the driver, as in not a transporter, it would have been them. They would have filed that as a comprehensive damage with their insurance company. So, to me, and I realize that I'm a little bit old-fashioned. You know, I still believe in old-fashioned things like the Constitution, like own your own mistakes, like pay your own way in the world. You know, those old-fashioned things that a lot of people like to throw by the wayside now. Which means I believe that if you choose, as the owner of a vehicle, to ship your vehicle open transport in order to save money, that you also are still accepting the inherent responsibility, the inherent risk of that comprehensive type damage, such as a rock ding to your paint or a windshield or hail damage or anything that is beyond the driver's control. Now, I know, again, that's old-fashioned way of thinking, and in this modern socialist government take care of everything, I don't need to be responsible for anything mentality that the world is coming to, that's a foreign way of thinking. Always blame somebody else, always have somebody else pay for your mistakes, never take the blame for anything. That's the way so many people are nowadays. Buyers that buy a vehicle and ship it, ends up breaking down during transport, or ended up being an in-op and it wasn't supposed to be, or whatever the case, they don't want to take the responsibility for that. They want that to be on the driver. And depending on the case, sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. Last video I put up about brokers, you saw I ended up being the one that had to eat that. The additional cost of, well, I'm a full day, well, more like a closer to 2 days behind now as a result of two vehicles that you saw in that last video. That's a couple thousand dollars right there, lost revenue. I can't get it back. Then, you know, all the headache that goes along with that, all the other upset customers because I'm not on schedule. It's a domino effect, and it's very, very difficult to recover from that. Fortunately, most of the customers were very understanding when we explained the situation, and they worked with us. And we've got all but one vehicle on now, getting ready to head back to Washington. And we are 10 miles from picking that one up. So anyway, I want to show you a video that will demonstrate the reason why it is so important to do a proper inspection on a vehicle. Because there's a lot of people out there that even if they know there's pre-existing damage, if you didn't put it on your bill of lading and they see a chance to take advantage of a trucking company's insurance policy, they're gonna do it. They're gonna get their car fixed on your dime because you didn't document the damage properly on your bill of lading. Now, I've got a still photo that a friend of mine just sent me. There's also a car hauler on another semi car. Maybe he's got an 8-car trailer. I forget now. But anyway, he was at an auction picking a vehicle up, a Land Rover or a Range Rover. He had done his walk around, and he just got this feeling he needed to look at the roof. Now, a lot of those vehicles are tall enough you can't just see the roof. If you don't open the door and step up on the running board, or if it has a running board, step up on, or open the door and step up on the rocker panel and look at the roof, you won't even know there's damage there. And if you don't document that damage on your gate pass before you leave the auction and leave that gate pass with the auction, you've got no proof whatsoever of when that damage occurred. Well, he happened to look up on the roof, and there was some major damage caused by a previous car hauler. Now, it's obvious that it's transport damage. Anybody in the industry would immediately recognize what the damage is. This vehicle was transported on the bottom deck of a car hauler without enough space between the roof and the top deck. And every time it bounced, it hit the top deck, and it did some significant damage. Now, I don't know whether that driver knew about it, didn't know about it, no idea. But the point is, if my friend hadn't done his inspection properly, there's a very good chance that he would have been blamed for this. And I'd say this is going to be thousands of dollars worth of damage. So y'all take a look at this photograph and then watch the video that I'll show you of a car that I have on my trailer right now. Check it out. Really, really nice little car. And it's fairly low to the ground. And you walk up and look it over, and it looks like it's pristine. But if you don't lay down on the ground, guess what you'll miss? Look at all those damages there. Can't see it from walking around it. You're only going to see it if you get right down close and look at it. Look at that. Looks like it probably hit a curb or something. Something else we noticed. Now, just walking around it, we didn't see this. All of these little pieces have popped out right here. See there? Apparently from whenever it hit something that did that damage. But as we're standing here putting this strap on and we're looking, it's right here close. Right here where we can see it. So, yep, very nice car. But if you don't get down on the ground, look up underneath it. Look up under on these rocker panels carefully. It will be extremely easy to miss a damage. And when you miss a damage, there's a very good chance that you're gonna have to pay for it, unless you have an intelligent broker that understands, because they've been there in the business long enough, what is and is not a transport damage. Now that could very easily be a transport damage, maybe from the last transporter, or it could be from running up on a curb by the driver. I don't know. All I know is we marked that damage before we loaded it, thankfully. For those of you that hung on until the end, thank you for supporting this YouTube channel that shows life on the road as a car hauler and makes an attempt at providing honest and up-to-date information about how to succeed in the car hauling industry. We appreciate every one of you that subscribes and shares and likes these videos. A big thank you from Doggo. Life is short. Live it well. Surround yourself with important people. Choose your saddle partners carefully, because they may turn on you without warning.
set a good example for tomorrow's saddle partners. Make sure you can look yourself in the mirror. The best view of the world is between the ears of a good horse. Never fail to look for the beauty in the world around you. Live your life in a way that inspires your children to go farther and be more. No regrets.